Hachette Audio presents The Great Equalizer, How Main Street Capitalism Can Create an Economy for Everyone. Written by David Smick. Read by Kiff VandenHeuvel. Preface. This is a unique moment in American history. Our president can shift people's expectations about the future to positive goals and actions. The choice is between being an ideological placeholder or becoming a truly transformational president. In a counterintuitive way, today's public anger and disillusionment over lack of economic opportunity have produced a rare chance to achieve positive change. The public's message to their Washington policymakers? We are tired of economic mediocrity at home and terrified of a dangerous world. We crave a healthier, more robust economy. We want constructive change. We don't care how you get there. Be creative. Be pragmatic. Try different things. Cut bipartisan deals. Just get there. We want an economic environment of bottom-up dynamism. When all is said and done, economic growth is everything. The Great Equalizer describes the new mindset that can achieve a better economy for everyone. It is a call for a set of new paradigms that inspire and empower average Americans to reboot their economy. It is a manifesto that argues with a new kind of economic policy of Main Street capitalism. America's best days are still to come. To be sure, many experts have concluded that America's best days are behind us, that mediocre long-term economic growth is baked in the cake, and that politically, socially, and racially, the United States will continue to tear itself apart. These experts are wrong. True, the economy faces stiff headwinds. The policy tools of macroeconomics have failed to achieve historic levels of economic performance. The central bankers have slashed interest rates and flooded the economy with liquidity. The economy has underperformed anyway. As a result, working and middle-class families can feel the American dream slipping away. For nearly two decades, their incomes have flatlined. Average folk are desperate. They yearn for a dynamic, jobs-producing economy that works for everyone. They know in their gut America needs a new economic approach. Americans feel besieged precisely because, in recent decades, a corporate capitalism of top-down mismanagement and backroom deal-making has smothered their innovative spirit. Government and central bank policy now favors the big, the corporate, and the status quo at the expense of the small, the young, the new, the inventive, and the entrepreneurial. It favors Wall Street over Main Street. Because the economic system is compromised, people can feel it in their bones that their children's future is being frittered away. In response, I envision a vibrant Main Street capitalism of mass small business startups and bottom-up innovation, all unfolding on a level playing field. Main Street capitalism is the great equalizer. It offers a climate of dynamism where every man or woman is a potential founder of a business startup. Women already start firms at twice the rate of men, based on 2014 data. Dramatic advancement by female entrepreneurs could become America's economic secret weapon. Just as important, Main Street capitalism especially empowers those at the bottom rungs of the economic ladder. As I'll show, the problem with today's economy is not a lack of monetary liquidity, but a lack of the liquidity of confidence. People are terrified of the future. Investors are holding back. Innovators are starting firms at less than half the rate they did two decades ago. There are reasons why America's economic dreamers and discoverers have become risk-averse. The economic system is rigged. In the fight between David and Goliath, Goliath always wins. And in Washington, D.C., a stifling partisanship has meant nothing ever gets done to fix things. Meanwhile, our infrastructure is crumbling. I argue that the political and legislative tactics of two past presidents, Republican Ronald Reagan and Democrat Bill Clinton, can offer a useful guide to better policymaking. Today, the world is a terrifying place of massive debt, currency wars, dubious asset prices, and excess supply capacity, while ISIS rears its ugly head all too often. The new information economy is replacing the old familiar brick-and-mortar one of manufacturing. Technological change is coming at people so fast they are overwhelmed. Can technological innovation be made to benefit everyone, and not just a select few in Silicon Valley and their investors on Wall Street? I contend that despite such daunting challenges, people are not going to give up on the American dream without a fight. Thankfully, innovative dreaming and discovering have always been in America's DNA. The United States has been a land of innovative daring. That is why the American economy has traditionally been a massive, high-growth, jobs-producing machine, a hothouse of commercially attractive creativity. The United States still has many advantages. The building blocks are still in place to achieve higher levels of economic success. Today's technology is sometimes feared, but actually, innovative advancements in information and other technologies can produce a powerful bottom-up growth phenomenon. Because people are more connected, great ideas are more easily found and shared. All human knowledge is at everyone's fingertips and essentially is free. The cost of reaching customers has never been cheaper. So, The Great Equalizer is ultimately an optimistic book about rebuilding an awesome economic growth engine that is beyond the economist's ability to model. To show the way, I offer Main Street Capitalism's 14-point plan of bipartisan reforms that can help unleash America's creativity and confidence. Ultimately, economies are more than statistical measurements of supply and demand, economic output, balance of payments deficits, and rates of return on capital. As I'll show, economies are people, their hopes, fears, dreams, and expectations. Economies entail what the English economist John Maynard Keynes in 1936 called the ebb and flow of animal spirits. Economies are flesh and blood. And that's the good news. Our economic future is not baked in the cake, nor is our economic destiny a matter of luck. Human creativity and initiative are not irrelevant in determining economic success or failure. The level of the people's innovative daring is not preset. Americans have a history of rising to the challenge. The Great Equalizer shows that with a new bottom-up economic approach, a more robust economy is within our grasp. Americans want their leaders to write a new economic narrative. They want to rediscover the thing that has always made them exceptional, their can-do attitude and audacious spirit, their willingness to dream big and to dare big. Average working families are desperate for higher rates of economic growth. But the time to write that new story of American economic dynamism is now. The clock is ticking. David M. Smick. Introduction. When I was thinking about writing a book about today's global tsunami of working and middle-class economic anger, it dawned on me that I may be both the worst and the best person to take on such a task. On the one hand, after a decade of working as a staffer on Capitol Hill and briefly in the U.S. auto industry, I have spent the last 30 years as a macroeconomic policy advisor to a number of world-class investors. I help my highly affluent clients war game the threats and opportunities to the global economy. I am an investor myself. On the other hand, I have also experienced life at a different level. I grew up in a working-class neighborhood in the city of Baltimore. My next-door neighbor drove a cement truck.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.